Hello everybody, today we are going to see derivation for the volume of cone, okay, with the help of volume of cylinder. Okay, so for that we are going to do one activity. That is, I have brought here some amount of sand, okay, and I have one right circular cylinder, okay, one model of right circular cylinder and model of right circular cone. Okay, so first we will see, with the help of cylinder we are going to prove formula for the volume of cone. Okay, so if you will observe here the height of both the cylinder and this is same. Okay, height of right circular cylinder and height of cone is same. Why it is called right circular cylinder, that we have seen. This is height of the cylinder, okay, this is circumference, and height of the cylinder is perpendicular to the base, so this is known as right circular cylinder. Okay, we have studied about this volume also, and third surface area, total surface area. Okay, so this is right circular cone, which is closed from one side and which is open from one side. Okay, which is open from top. Okay, so this is right circular cylinder and this is right circular cone. Okay, why it is called right circular cone? Because this is the slant height, vertical height is perpendicular to the base. Okay, and this is open from the base and this is the top vertex that we have studied. This is slant height, vertical height, this is base. Okay, one similarity is from both of these, this cylinder and this cone. Here see, here you will observe, then here circumference of both right circular cone and right circular cylinder is same. Okay, circumference is same, means we can say radius same. Okay, radius of right circular cylinder, this cylinder, and radius of cone is same. Also height of both, height of this and height of cone and height of cylinder is same. Okay, so for some time we will consider height h. Okay, height of this cylinder and this cone is h, and radius always we take small r. So we will take radius r, understood? So two things are same, height and radius of right circular cone and right circular cylinder, understood? So now everybody knows the volume, how to find out volume of right circular cylinder. Right circular cylinder, volume of right circular cylinder is equals to, everybody knows, this is area of this is pi r square multiplied by height. So volume will be pi r square h. This is the volume of the right circular cylinder, means this cylinder whose radius is r, radius is small r, and height is h. Okay, with the help of this we are going to find out volume of cone, understood? So for that we are going to do one simple activity. Okay, I have brought here some amount of sand. Okay, now what I am going to do here, actually I am going to put this sand here in the cone, understood? And that I will empty in the cylinder. Okay, like that activity we are going to do. So first time I am taking now here sand, okay, volume is, everybody knows, okay, the capacity of the container, that is known as volume. So capacity of this cone is equals to the volume of cone. So this is, I have taken here sand, now that I am going to empty in this cylinder. Okay, still there is lot of space, understood? So I need to put some more amount of sand. Okay, so that I am taking now here. So again one more time I have taken, so that I will work empty once again here. Okay, so now again there is some space, so I am going to use some more sand. So this is third time I am taking. Okay, so now it will observe here, see, now when I have taken third time, that time this cylinder is completely filled, understood, and this is now empty, okay. So when this is now completely filled, okay, and how many times I have taken this is three times, I have taken this three times. Say in short, we can say the volume of volume of cylinder, okay, or we can say with the help of this we can say volume of pole is one third of volume of cylinder pi r square h, one third of pi r square h. So this we can write 1/3 into pi r square h. Understood? How many times we have taken this? Three times to fill this cylinder. Okay, whose radius and height is equal. Radius of this means circumference is equal. So definitely its radius is equal. Also height is same. Okay, so when you will take three times this, that time this will fill. Here you can use water also. Understood? So volume of pole is equal to 1/3 pi r square. Okay, so first problem which is depend on the volume of cone, that is find the volume of a right circular cone of 1.02 meter high if the radius of its base is 28 centimeter. Okay, so what is given? See, find the volume of a right circular cone 1.02 meter high. This is the height of the right circular cone. Understood? Means height is given here. Height is equal to 1.02 meters. Okay. And what is given? If the radius of its base is 28 centimeters. Radius is given. So radius is equal to 28 centimeters. Okay. Here one thing is there. This is in centimeter and this is in meter. Understood? So we need to make unit symbols. Okay. So height we can, this meter we can convert into centimeter easily by multiplying by 100. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So h is equal to what? When you multiply by 100, that time you will get 102 centimeter. So height is 102 centimeter and radius is 28 centimeter. Understood? Now here we have to find out volume. Okay, just now we have seen formula for volume of right circular pole is equals to what? Is equals to 1/3 pi r square h. 1/3 pi r square h. Understood? This formula just now we have seen. So now is equal to, just we have to put the values. Pi is 22/7. Radius is given 28 centimeter. So 28 multiplied by 28 into height is 102 centimeter. This is volume, so it will come in cube. Understood? So now here we can take 7. 7 4s are 28. Here 3 1s are 3. 3 3s are 9. And 1 remain, 3 4s are 12. Okay. So finally we need to multiply 22 4s are 88. Multiply by 28. Multiply by 34 centimeter cube. Understood? We have to find out product of these three. And that product will get 83,776 centimeter cube. Okay, so this is very simple example which is depend on only one concept, that is volume of right circular cone is 1/3 pi r square h. Just we have to put the values and then you will get the answer. Next problem is the diameter of a right circular cone is 8 centimeter and its volume is 48 pi centimeter cube. What is its height? We have to find out height of the cone. Understood? What is given? The diameter of a right circular cone is given. Diameter is given, so we can find out easily its radius. Okay. And its volume is given. Volume is 48 pi centimeter cube. Understood? So three things are given and we have to find out height of the cone. Okay. So diameter is given 8 centimeter. Okay, so we can find out radius. So radius will be small r, that is 4 centimeter. Half of the diameter is radius. Okay, so this is one thing. And what is given? Volume is given. Volume is 48 pi centimeter cube. Okay, and we have to find out height of the cone. Okay, so directly we can use here formula. So that is volume of cone volume of cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, 1 by 3 pi r square h. This is unknown value, so that we have to find out. Okay, so volume of cone is given 48 pi centimeter cube is equal to 1 by 3 multiply by pi multiply by r square. What is r? 4 centimeters. So 4 into 4 multiply by height. Understood? So now here this pi, this side pi and that side pi, we can cancel easily because value is same. So now 4 4s are 16. So what is going to remain here? 48 is equal to 4 4s are 16 by 3 into h. 4 into 4, 16 by 3 into h. So h is equals to what? H equals to 48 multiplied by 3 divided by 16. Reciprocal 16 by 3, 3 by 16. So 16 ones are 16, 16 threes are 48. Okay. So height is equals to what? 3 threes are 9 centimeter. Understood? So here we got the height. Understood? So if other values are given, we can find out unknown value very easily with the help of this formula. Okay. Thank you.